أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا يسخر قوم من قوم عسى أن يكونوا خيرا منهم ولا نساء من نساء عسى أن يكن خيرا منهن ولا تلمزوا أنفسكم ولا تنابزوا بالألقاب بئس الاسم الفسوق بعد الإيمان ومن لم يتب فأولئك هم الظالمون. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Quran Weekly. I begin by praising and thanking Allah Azza wa Jalla. Alhamdulillah, salatu wassalam ala Rasulillah. I wanted to take these few moments to share with you a reminder that I myself need, and I think most of us need, in regards to guarding and respecting the gift that Allah has given us, our tongues. Allah Azza wa Jal, when He revealed the Qur'an, He mentioned some of His most exquisite mercies and gifts. So He said, Ar-Rahman allama al-Qur'an. One of the points to ponder about those ayat in Surah Ar-Rahman is that He mentioned not just a name that depicts His mercy, that a name that depicts His extreme mercy. Ar-Rahman, the unimaginably merciful, the one being incredibly merciful. Allama al-Qur'an, He taught the Qur'an. And the Qur'an, of course, is the speech of Allah. The speech of Allah that once He revealed it is supposed to be on our tongues, and we're supposed to remind each other with it, so the words that we utter from our mouths are supposed to actually be a means of penetrating somebody else's heart. Then He says, خَلَقَ الْإِنسَانِ, He created the human being, and then He used the same word, allama, which is amazing. He said, allama al-Qur'an, He taught the Qur'an. In other words, He taught His speech, and then a skip over an ayah, and you find allamahu al-bayan. He taught the human being speech. Just like He said He taught the Qur'an, He said He taught speech. The ability to speak is an incredible gift from Allah, and it's an honor from Allah. And what we're learning in those ayat is the best use of your speech is to remember Allah by the words He taught you. Or to be in your speech in any matter should be inspired by the speech that Allah has taught you, the one that He honored us with, His Qur'an. Now, we're all human, we make mistakes, and we sometimes don't realize the value of things that we have, especially our tongues, and we say things, and we make comments, and you know, in social settings among friends, family, things like that, that completely cross the line sometimes, and we don't realize the magnitude of that problem. And because Allah Azza wa Jal takes the time to mention this particular problem in the Qur'an, it should make us appreciate that this is not a light matter. In that regard, I just wanted to share as this reminder from Qur'an Weekly, just one ayah from Surah Al-Hujurat. And this is ayah number 11. It's an address to those who believe. And the first thing Allah says is, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا يَسْخَرْ قَوْمٌ مِّن قَوْمٍ. Those of you who believe, don't let any group among you, any nation, which implies any group, any collectivity, poke fun at any other. And sakhira or sukhriya in Arabic is not just to poke fun, because the word for that is istahza'a also, but a more comprehensive word in Arabic, sukhriya, actually means to be sarcastic also. Don't be sarcastic against each other. Now, making fun of someone or being sarcastic against someone, a lot of times, especially nowadays, it's considered like a sign of intelligence. That guy's really funny. That guy makes a lot of funny jokes. Or he's got a lot of sarcastic remarks that are like rapid fire. They come out of him one after another. And when people around you laugh at your joke, you figure, hey, this is kind of, it's pretty much an ego boost, right? So you come up with the next diss, or the next sarcastic remark, or the next inappropriate joke, and you kind of feed off of the laughter of others. So you can get caught up in this thing. And Allah Azza wa Jalla is telling us in this surah that this is something that can take away the very fabric of the brotherhood we enjoy among each other. Allah Azza wa Jalla, in the previous, the ayah right before this one, He says, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةً. Believers are nothing but brothers among each other. فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَ أَخَوَيْكُمْ. Then make reconciliation between your brothers. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. And be, you know, have the taqwa of Allah so you may be shown mercy. Be conscious, aware, and in awe of Allah so you may be shown mercy. The previous ayah is talking about us making reconciliation among each other, and the very next ayah is saying, watch the way you speak to each other. Don't be sarcastic with each other. Don't make, you know, insulting comments in the name of humor against each other. You know, very casual to say, to talk about how short someone is, or how ugly they are, or how they dress, or what kind of car they drive, or what school they go to, or what kind of job they have. Very easy to pick on someone's flaws and kind of make them a point of ridicule. Then Allah says, عَسَىٰ أَن يَكُونُوا خَيْرًا مِّنْهُمْ. You know, خَيْرًا, it may be that the group making fun of the other may be better than the group that's being made fun of may be better. Now, maybe better by whose perspective? Obviously, when you make fun of someone, there's already an underlying assumption, conscious or subconscious, that you're better than them. That's why they're the object of your ridicule. You know, you wouldn't take someone who you are convinced deserves more respect than you do, or is above you in any way. They wouldn't be the point of ridicule for you. So obviously there's a sense of superiority you have. Allah is saying, as far as He's concerned, the group you're making fun of may be better. And here another just note about our society in general, something that's just become part of comedy and entertainment. You know, a comic, a stand-up comic, someone who cracks a lot of jokes, things like that. One of their kind of sellers is to mock another ethnicity, to kind of imitate an accent, and you know, make fun of what kind of food that ethnicity likes to eat, or how they dress, or the kinds of weird things they say among each other, or how they drive their cars, or how cheap they are, or how much they love spicy food, whatever what kind of hot tempers they have. So you pick on some flaw of some ethnicity, and you make that the object of ridicule, which makes this ayah even more alive. You know, لا يسخر قوم من قوم. Not any group making fun of any other group. Maybe the group you're making fun of is better than you, as far as Allah is concerned, that is to say. وَلَا نِسَاءٌ مِّن نِسَاءٍ. Which is interesting. Allah said, and neither should women be making fun of other women. In other words, Allah mentioned nations, which includes men and women, but Allah specifically highlighted women doing so. And so what is being told here, because of the word سُخْرِيَّة, is that the way women do this may be very different than the way men do it.